Welcome back to The Race, I'm Dan Grossman. The pandemic forced many companies to come up with ways to make remote work possible.
Alicia Nieves is with a woman who says the shift has her working for the first time in more than 15 years.
While many people lost their jobs over the past few months,
hi, how can I help you?
For some people, the pandemic caused a scenario that made it easier to find work. LaShonda Garner is one of those people.
In my situation, I was out of work for 16 years.
After nearly two decades, Garner found a work-from-home job at the start of the pandemic.
As soon as I got the job, I was thrilled. I was like, oh my God, I can actually do something past my disability.
Garner suffers from severe PTSD and anxiety that makes it difficult to work in a traditional work environment.
In my case, there's certain sounds, there's certain smells, there's different things that trigger your anxiety. Anxiety or depression. And when I'm at home, I can limit those things.
While previously work from home options were limited, during forced business closures and stay at home orders, the U.S. saw a surge in work from home jobs, especially call center positions.
The pandemic struck, all of the call centers had to send their agents home. And this is worldwide. And this is something that never happened before. And some of the agents that were sent home in India, the Philippines, and China didn't have the infrastructure in order to do those jobs.
Alan Hubbard is with the National Telecommuting Institute, which helps people with disabilities work from home.
All right, whenever you're ready.
LaShonda is actually one of many people with disabilities who have been able to find work from home jobs and thrive in that environment in the past few months. The company that helped her, NTI, has actually been able to place nearly 200 other people in the last 6 weeks, when typically they only are able to place about 50 people a month.
And that's what the pandemic has done. It's opened up this opportunity for these folks.
Hubbard is working with a dozen companies looking to hire another 240 people, while LaShonda is thriving in her current role and hoping her story inspires others.
Fight for what you want, because you will eventually get it. It may take you, hopefully not 16 years like me, but you will end up getting it.
For The Race, I'm Alicia Nieves reporting.
How gig workers are navigating the new job market, next.